Welcome to this How to Wire a Three-Way Switch video. Here you will learn the steps for the easiest method to installing a three-way light switch. There are several ways to install a three-way switch circuit. This method brings power into the two switches before going to the light. To install a three-way circuit using this method, you will need two three-way switches and a three-wire cable that will run between the switches. The other cables running to the power source and the light are two-wire cables. After installing your handy boxes where you want the light switches, you are ready to pull the wire from the power source into the first box. The wire should come into the box through the knockout that is closest to the direction the wire is coming from. I like to remove the sheathing from the wires before bringing them into the box. This makes it easier to remove than cutting it once it is inside the box. You want to remove about 9 inches of sheathing from the wires. This will give you 3 inches of wire inside the box and about 6 inches of wire outside the box. Pull the cable that will supply power to the circuit into the box until the sheathing comes into the box about a half an inch. After installing the main power wire into the first box, you will install a three-wire cable from the first box to the second box. The extra wire in this cable is what allows power to go between the switches, even when the first switch is in the off position. Remove the sheathing from one end of the three-wire cable and install it into the first box. Use a cable staple to support the cables outside the box. Current electrical codes require boxes without a clamp to have the wire supported within 8 inches of the box. After the wires are supported, you will pull the three-wire cable into the second box. If you are drilling horizontally through the wall studs, you will use a 3/4 inch drill bit and drill in the center of the wall studs so that drywall screws cannot hit the cable. Measure the three-wire cable length so that you will have at least 9 inches of wire inside the second box and will also be able to support the cable outside the box, and then cut the cable to length. Strip the cable sheathing from the wires and pull the wires into the box. Now you are ready to pull the cable between the light and the second switch. Strip 9 inches of cable sheathing from the end of a two-wire cable and pull the two-wire cable into the second switch box. After the two-wire cable and three-wire cable are brought into the second box, use a cable staple to support the cables outside the box. Now, pull the two-wire cable coming out of the second switch box to the light box. Strip the sheathing as before and pull the wires into the light box. Use a cable staple to support the cable within 8 inches of the box. After the four cable ends are in the two boxes, you will strip the individual wire ends of their sheathing. You want to take 1 inch of insulation off the ends of each of the wires. Doing this now helps keep the carpets clean when we come through to install the switch and trim. After the sheathing is off, you will bend the ends of the black and red wires so that they can go around the terminals on the light switches. Use the holes in the sides of your wire strippers to bend the ends of the wires into a cane shape. This can also be done using needle nose pliers. The white wires and ground wires are left straight so that they can be connected using wire nuts. In the first box, you will attach white wires from the two and three wire cables to each other using wire nuts. Twist the wire nuts until they are tight and the wires outside the nut are twisted several times. Then attach the ground wires to each other and also add a 6-inch piece of ground wire to the connection so you can fasten it to the switch. This extra wire is called a pigtail. You can now push the wires into the box. Fold the wires into the box from the top to the bottom so that they can easily be pulled back out of the box, just like an accordion opens. In the second box, you will make the same connections you did in the first box. After bending the ends of the black and red wires so that they can be attached to the switch, you will tie the white wires together using a wire nut. Then attach the ground wires to each other and also add a 6-inch pigtail. Fold the wires into the box so that they can be pulled out when the switch is installed. To prepare the light box wires, you will simply fold them into the box. After the drywall, paint, and trim are installed, you will come back to the boxes and install the switches and light. We will now show you how to install the switches. Start with the first box and pull the wires out of the box. Using a three-way switch, attach the black wire from the two-wire power source cable to the common screw on the switch. Make sure that the wires wrap around the screws in the clockwise direction so that they wind tightly when the screws are tightened. Then attach the black and red wires that go to the three-wire cable to the two traveler screws on the switch. The traveler screws are opposite each other on the switch. Finally, attach the ground wire to the ground terminal on the switch. After the wires are attached to the switch, you are ready to fold the wires back into the box and fasten the switch to the handy box. Attaching the second switch to the wires in the second box is very similar to the first box. The only difference is that the common terminal on the switch is attached to the power wire going to the light. Using a three-way switch, attach the black wire going out to the two-wire light cable to the common screw on the switch. Then, attach the black and red wires that go to the three-wire cable coming from the first switch to the two traveler screws on the switch. Finally, attach the ground wire to the ground terminal on the switch. Now, fold the wires back into the box and attach the switch to the box. Continue learning about electrical projects by clicking on one of these videos. Thanks for watching.